Welcome to the first class. Now, here I'll be doing two sums with you, interesting sums. All right, so this is the question. Three positive real numbers A, B, and C are such that both the triplets A, B, and C and 1 over A, 1 over B, 1 over C form sides of two right angled triangles. So you have got one right angled triangle with sides A, B, and C, and another right angle triangle, 1 over A, 1 over B, 1 over C. If theta is the smallest angle in the right angle triangle formed by the first triplet, this A, B, and C. If theta is the smallest angle in the right angle triangle formed by the first triplets A, B, and C, then show that sine of theta is this one, root 5 minus 1 over 2. Another thing I must tell you that whenever I give you some sums, I do not always expect you to do it completely. What I want to see is that how you are approaching the sum, what you are doing, where you are getting stuck. Those things I want to know. I want to see how far you have proceeded. So, in future, if I give you a sum and in my class you said that I could not solve it, my question will be to you that show me where you got stuck. Where, what did you think of and where you got stuck? It is more important over here is your learning than my teaching. I can do it, continue teaching over the board, in the board or over the slides. But if you do not learn, then that has no value. So you have to do sums yourself. The theory portions I will do. I will definitely make sure that theory portions are covered. I will do a few sums, but the major chunk of the sums you have to do by yourself. It will not be done, all the exercises done in the class and you just copy them and do it there. No. Okay. It will not be any mugging up business. You have to do sums by yourself. So, in that process, I do not expect you to always finish the sum completely. What I want is, what I want to see is how far you have proceeded with the sum. How are you thinking? Where you got stuck? How do you approach a particular sum? All these things I want to see. Solution. Without loss of generality, let us assume 0 less than a 4, A less than B less than C. Let us understand what is this without loss of generality. So three numbers A, B, C are given. Then, so anything can be, anyone can be bigger than the other. Okay, it may be A equal to 3, B equal to 2 and C equal to 1. Then this thing is not possible, right? So then why do we assume without loss of generality? Suppose this means that if we assume this, we do not lose anything, anything in particular. Suppose we have three numbers, 1, 2, and 3. Now, we may assign A to be 1, B to be 2, and C to be 3. We may call whatever three numbers we have, we may call the smallest one as A, middle one as B, and the biggest one is C. So, we can always assume that this A is less than B is less than C. In this way, the other cases, B less than A less than C or C less than B less than A, these cases can also appear, but that will not give us any extra result. That is what is meant by without loss of generality. Suppose I want to talk about, say, in a very crude sense, human anatomy. Okay, human anatomy and not into much of physiology, but in the basic anatomy. So every human has got two hands, two legs, one face, one mouth, two nostrils, two eyes, two ears, a head, and this thing. Now over here, in this description, it doesn't matter. The description I have given you so far, in this description, it doesn't matter whether I have chosen a male or a female, whether I have chosen a man or a woman. So in, if we are interested in the description I have given you, only in the description I have given you, then it does not make any difference whether we choose a male or a female. So that means the general description of a human being, general description of the portion I just told you, that does not depend on the particular choice of male or female. So that is what we say without loss of generality. We are not, we are talking about a human in general, but we are choosing a particular, we are choosing a particular body, let's say of a female. Then we are not losing anything over there. So whatever things, whatever properties of a female body we are interested in, that is same are the properties in common in a male body as well. So we are not losing any generality. Though we are choosing a particular body of a female, but still we can, we are getting the general idea, general knowledge about both the sexes. Is that clear? This is what is meant by without loss of generality. We often abbreviate this as WLOG. Okay, this is without loss of generality. So we are going to conclude about something general, but we are assuming something particular. And we claim that there it does not matter when we assume something particular. The general idea will be still be maintained. So without loss of generality, let us assume A less than B less than C. And everything is positive, that is given there. Then in the first triangle, C must be the hypotenuse because the hypotenuse is the biggest side. So this is my triangle. A, B and C. So this is my biggest side, that is C. Fine. Now, therefore, by Pythagoras theorem, we have a square plus b square equal to c square. No problem. Then also, since a is the smallest over here, a is the smallest, the angle opposite to the side a must be the smallest angle theta. This is the opposite angle. So that means a is the height here. Okay, opposite angle is theta. So a is the height. Okay, if that was the adjacent angle, then in that case, a would be base. So A is the height here, since it is the opposite angle theta we are talking about. So this is my theta. Theta is the smallest angle in the right angle triangle formed by the first set. So this is my theta. So therefore, over here, sine theta is height over hypotenuse, that is A over C. Clear? So this sine theta, the value of this ratio, we are going to find out in this question. Fine. Now, taking reciprocals over here, if we take reciprocals, what do we get? 1 over A is greater than 1 over B is greater than 1 over C, right? Inequality sign will change if you take reciprocals. So therefore, in the second triangle, 1 over A is the biggest side. So therefore, that will be the hypotenuse. Isn't it? So by Pythagoras again, we get 1 over B square plus, yes. 1 by C should be the smallest, but I do not care. I do not care because I need to only convince, I mean, we need to only be concerned about the smallest one in the first triangle, not in the second one. Theta is the smallest angle in the right angle triangle formed by the first set of sides. I do not care in here whether something is theta or what is the smallest angle side. I do not care. I only need to know which one is the hypotenuse. In that way, we'll be able to apply Pythagoras. Are you confused that here I have written 1 over B and here? Oh, okay. So this thing is not properly scaled. This one is not properly scaled. I mean, this can be a little longer, this can be a little shorter. I do not mind. This one is not properly scaled. Okay, there is no relation between this triangle and this triangle. There is no theta over here. Only it is right angle triangle. And the hypotenuse is 1 over A. That's it. Nothing else. Okay. I am not claiming the smallest side is 1 by B here. I am not claiming smallest side is this one. And this one is not the smallest side. I am not claiming that. I am only claiming that this one is the biggest side. That's it. Okay. So, therefore, in the second triangle, 1 by A is the hypotenuse. Hence, by Pythagoras theorem again, 1 over A square is equals to 1 over B square plus 1 over C square. Right? So call this equation double star. So our job reduces to solve for A over C. The question asks for to find sine theta. Sine theta is a over c. So our job is to solve for a over c from this star and from this double star. Okay. So from star, what do we get? This is my star. What I want to do, I want to find a over c. So I divide by c. I divide by c square throughout. So I get a square over c square plus b square over c square is equal to 1. So I get a square over c square plus b square over c square is equal to 1. And from double star we get, I here and multiply with c square. So it is c square over a square is equal to c square over b square plus 1. Right? This means c square over b square is equal to c square over a square minus 1. Okay? I'm trying to remove this c square by b square term. So this means b square over c square, this was c square over b square, this is b square over c square is the reciprocal of the everything. So 1 over this entire thing, c square over a square minus 1. Write t for a over c. Okay, just a over c is looking clumsy. So just write t for a over c. So then finally we get over here. Over here you see a over c is your t. So a square over c square is t square. Okay, so a square over c square is t square. Now b square over c square, this is b square over c square. So this is 1 over c square by a square. Now c square by a square is 1 by t square, because a square by c square is t square. So this is 1 by t square minus 1. T square goes up, t square over 1 minus t square. Fine, it's equal to 1. Next step is you multiply t square minus t to the power 4 plus t square is equal to 1 minus t square. T to the power 4 goes this side, you have plus 2 t square on this side. So if it goes to this side, it will be minus 3 t square, and then plus 1 is equals to 0 on the left hand side, and then you switch everything on the other side. So t to the power 4 minus 3 t square plus 1 is equals to 0. See, this one is a quadratic equation in t square, right? This is t square whole square minus 3 times t square plus 1 is equals to 0. If you use the Sridhar Acharya rule, then it is minus b. This is minus b minus or minus 3, that is plus 3, plus or minus square root b square. B square is minus 3 whole square, that is 9, minus 4ac. 4 into a is 1 and c is 1. So 9 minus 4. So 3 plus minus root over 5 over 2. As t is sine theta, the value of t square must be non-negative and less than 1. Okay, sine theta, value of sine theta is between minus 1 and 1. So the value of sine square theta must be between 0 and 1. So 0 less than or equal to t square less than or equal to 1. How out of these two values over here, 3 plus minus square root of 5 over 2, which value falls within this restriction 0 to 1? How much is square root of 5? 2 point something. So if I take the plus sign, if I take the plus sign over here, then it will be 3 plus 2 point something. So it will be 5 point something. 5 point something. Now 5 point something over 2 is how much? 2 point something. Right? So if I take the plus sign, then this value does not fall into this category. It becomes greater than 1. Right? But if I take the minus sign, so 3 minus 2 point something is 0 point something. So 0 point something over 2 is again 0 point something. Yeah, so this one, so minus sign if I take, then this value falls into this category, this restriction. So therefore from triple star, I choose t square, the value of t square as 3 minus square root of 5 over 2. Okay. So this is, if I multiply by 2 on numerator and denominator, I get 6 minus 2 root 5 over 4. So this is, 6 is 5 plus 1, so that is square root of 5 whole square plus 1 minus, this 2 into 5 is 2 into 1 into root 5 over 4. So the numerator is root 5 minus 1 whole square, and the denominator is 2 square. So the entire thing is root 5 minus 1 over 2 whole square. So the only admissible value for t is root 5 minus 1 over 2, because we are talking about acute angle theta. And for acute angle, sine theta is actually positive. So I should not take the negative square root of this thing. So I take the positive square root. So therefore, it is root 5 minus 1 over 2. Right? That is what was asked in the question. Hence, t sine theta. So sine theta is root 5 minus 1 over 2. This completes the proof. All right. Yeah, over here. So this is t square. I will be uploading this note in the link of the YouTube video. You do not need to copy. I'll be uploading this note over there, this PDF file. You do not need to copy. Is that clear? So, just by simple simplification over here, did you understand this part? T square plus 1 over t square minus 1 is equals to 1. So you simplify first on this term. So this t square goes up, and this is 1 minus t square. And then you simplify again t square into 1 minus t square. So t square minus 2 to the power 4 plus t square. This t square is equals to 1. This goes over here, 1 minus t square. And this t square, t to the power 4 minus 3t square plus 1. So this is a quadratic equation in t square. T square whole square minus 3t square plus 1 is equals to 0. So t square is equals to this one. Okay, so that's it. Right, so now this question I chose to show you how do we attack a particular sum. We start with something, what was given there, something, there is no particular choice of A, B, and C. So we assume some value and some relation between them, A, B, and C, and then we start. And that choice is without loss of generality. If we just assume this, then everything falls into the line. Only thing is, you just assume A less than B less than C. That's it. Everything falls into line after that. Clear? Okay. Next question. In a right angle triangle ABC, AB equal to AC equals to 18 centimeter, let D and E be the midpoint of AB and AC respectively. Join DC and BE respectively. Let them intersect at F. Find the area of FDB. So this is your homework for today.